The world was unpredictable even before the crisis. And now, utter confusion, uncertainty, and unpredictability have set in. As people with pre-existing condition were subject to higher risk, same applies to the organizations. If you went into crisis with problems, you are unlikely to survive without heavy losses. If you were stronger to start with, you are in a better position to come out of the immediate crisis and face the new normal for years to come. Sustainability in organizational management is all about looking into the future. Sustainable organizations create value by bearing in mind the long-term preservation and enhancement of financial, environmental, and social capital. In other words, achieving success today without compromising the needs of the future. Organizations need to be aware of key trends shaping the society and the particular field. They need to define possible risks and develop plans for mitigating those risks. Plan for risks, assess the risks, prepare for risks, and be happy if they never realize. Building scenarios can be a powerful tool. Instead of predicting the future, you prepare for alternative futures for informed decision-making. A change is gonna come, sang Sam Cooke back in 1964. We need to understand how profound changes will impact our organization in short and long term. This leads to the need for organizational resilience. According to the BCI, organizational resilience is the ability of organization to anticipate, prepare for, respond, and adapt to incremental change and sudden disruptions in order to survive and prosper. Readjusting the organization and aligning the team takes effort and courage. Changes in organization can be incremental or radical. When the world changes radically, the organization needs to be ready to change radically as well. As Philip Kern has correctly noted, in times when politicians are dividing the world as essentials and non-essentials, we need to make sure they understand that culture and creativity are absolutely part of the essentials. Cultural organizations need to be able to understand and highlight their wider impact, not just in terms of economic impact, but also in other domains, in education, in environmental awareness, in social inclusion, in building tolerance and trust, in rehabilitation, in healthcare, and in overall well-being. The new normal pushes us to rethink our value proposition, even our entire business or operating model. Looking at the Osterwalder business model canvas, we need to focus both on the right side of the model, our audiences or customers' needs, our value proposition to satisfy those needs, to changing or disrupted channels to get to our audiences and the types of relationships we create with them. But also we need to reimagine the left side of the model. How can we offer our products and services? What kind of resources, skills and partnerships we need for this? BCI and Granfield School of Management have found that organizational resilience has been split by two core drivers: defensive, stopping bad things happen, and progressive, making good things happen. The first phases are driven by defensive perspective that focuses on loss avoidance and value preservation. It soon became recognized that organizational resilience was not only about learning to bounce back, but also the ability to bounce forward and to grow and prosper in the future. Thus, organizational resilience is created through creating, inventing, and exploring unknown markets and new technologies. Being innovative, agile, and lean are important elements of organizational competitiveness in all times, but especially during the crisis. Museums, for instance, have seen more digital offering in past 2 months than in past 5 years. Agility and innovation management are not just processes, but ways of thinking. It is an organizational mindset, which includes lean management, design thinking, and other tools. The only certain thing in this uncertain world is that the world keeps changing and we need to prepare ourselves for it. We need to create learning organizations where people, skills and competences are continuously developed. Agile organizations which are not afraid of testing, experimenting, prototyping and failing as part of the learning curve. and resilient organizations, which are not just sitting in the back seat of the change, but which are proactively shaping the future. Whatever the world looks like tomorrow, it still needs meaning. It still needs to identify itself. It still wants to enjoy and laugh and think and heal. And therefore, it still needs arts and culture. And above all, it still needs creativity to prepare itself for whatever comes next.